It was an act of defiance leading to the American Revolution. Tons of tea dumped into Boston Harbor. Colonists had had enough. Taxed by British leaders they never elected. Well, 237 years later, a new kind of tea party. Only now, the resistance is against our own lawmakers and how they spend your tax dollars. Tea parties nationwide today and here at home. But will their momentum result in a new political party in Nebraska? Todd Andrews is live.
We're talking two tea parties today, Rob. About 500 people at one in West Omaha, and a couple hundred people were here at one earlier today in downtown Omaha. Organizers tell us they love the momentum they think they're getting from this, especially ahead of the November elections, but they believe it should remain a movement and not become a political party here.
From petitioning Congress for a balanced budget,
registering people today,
to lessons in American history.
If you go to Federalist Paper 48, written by James Madison,
you could say the theme at the Metro's two tax day tea parties is back to the basics.
We want to educate people about what the Constitution says.
For some 500 attendees at Walnut Grove Park in West Omaha and a few hundred downtown, that means things reflected in the signs they're bringing. Less taxes, controlled federal spending, limited government. Many here say they're new to politics, the Tea Party movement having sparked their interest.
We felt like it was time for us to come and stand with them.
Lifelong career politician, watch out. Because I think the American people are fed up with it.
We got to get up and we got to do something about it if we want to change the government in America.
The West Omaha Events conservative message crescendos with a speech from State Attorney General John Bruning.
For those of us that want less government, this is thrilling. This is important to the future of our country.
Organizers say they like the momentum but believe the Tea Party should remain a movement and not become a ballot choice.
We really don't want the Tea Party movement to become a third party. We think that would be divisive.
It could benefit us, you know, here in Nebraska.
That's if the movement were to become a party, Douglas County Democratic Party Chair Mike Leahy says. But he's not counting on that. That said, Leahy is watching events like these closely.
To me, it really exemplifies a divide, if you will, among Republicans and conservatives.
Bruning also gave an update tonight on the lawsuit Nebraska joined, challenging the constitutionality of the new federal health care law. Bruning says there are now 19 states on board, and they're making progress every day. Live in downtown Omaha, Todd Andrews, KETV News Watch 7.